I think it's fair to say that between the 1950s and the 1980s, Italy has owned car design more than any other nationality. Most enthusiasts will certainly know the names most associated with Italy's mastery of this discipline. But what if I told you there's someone who styled an incredible 1,200 different cars, almost single-handedly? That man was Giovanni Michelotti, and on the 100th year from his birth, Turin's National Automobile Museum dedicated a long overdue homage to his work and legacy. Michelotti could create such a disproportionate body of work thanks to a combination of sheer talent and hard work, but also thanks to unique circumstances. After years of working at Stabilimenti Farina, Giovanni Michelotti opened his own studio in Turin around 1949, and there couldn't have been a better time and place to do so. Dozens of small coach building firms each year showed their wares at Turin's motor show, and many took advantage of Michelotti's talent, like Vignale, Bertone, Allemano or Ghia. This meant that Michelotti often had several cars he designed on display contemporarily each year at the Turinese show. However, the average visitor would have been none the wiser, as Michelotti's involvement was rarely publicized by his clients, who were much more interested in putting their own names under the spotlight. Nevertheless, Michelotti soon became well known within the automobile industry, leading to long-running collaborations with several automakers, like DAF, BMW, and even Hino, a Japanese firm acquired by Toyota in 1967. For BMW, Michelotti styled two models that would become hugely important for the Bavarian market, the 700 and the 1500. These two models laid the foundations for the company's successful expansion in the latter part of the 20th century, and some of the 1500's styling cues would be carried on for decades on subsequent models. But if there's an automaker whose image and fortunes have been inextricably linked with Michelotti, that is undoubtedly Triumph. Michelotti styled the British marque's most renowned vehicles, like the Herald and the Roadster's TR4 and Spitfire, plus its sexy coupé derivative, the GT6. I only wish the exhibition could have included a stag, but those are rare south of the Alps, as the model was never officially imported in Italy. According to a 1978 magazine interview, Michelotti's favorite among his creations was indeed a Triumph, the Spitfire. Having owned one myself many years ago, I can definitely see why. It may have been slow and shoddily constructed, but boy, it looked gorgeous. My favorite details on the car were the bonnet catches, which bore an embossed M for Michelotti, in a delightfully subtle homage to the model's creator. Perhaps fittingly, the last car Giovanni Michelotti ever worked on, before his habit of going through up to 60 cigarettes per day caught up with him, was another British roadster, the Reliant Scimitar SS1. Michelotti prematurely passed away in 1980, and I wish to dedicate this video to his memory. Thank you for watching.